boys and girls of the shaft! In today's very exciting video, we're gonna be going super in-depth on the Big T. Go! So how do you get yourself one of these massive beasts, huh? Well, it's a new taming concept that we haven't really seen before, at least not like this. To tame the Big T, you have to lure a swarm of parakeet fish, annoying little frickers that will target you like those mosquitoes in the bog. When you're being targeted, you'll get this message telling you you're being targeted. Thanks. You have to lead the microbe swarm over to the giant turtle, where you have to try and get them to target it rather than you. It can be pretty tricky, as these fish do a lot of damage if they hit you, are easily distracted, and there are tons of dangers in the ocean biome to be aware of. There's typhoons, which while not dealing that much damage will suck you in and throw you around. Not to mention the dozens of hungry sea monsters wanting to eat you, like eels, sharks, and basically everything. But once you get the fish to the turt, it isn't job over. You have to guard the turdy from all dangers while it's getting targeted by the fish. This includes saber-toothed salmon that will come out of nowhere to target you, and all the other previously mentioned dangers of the sea. And if anything hits your tame while the process is going on, the taming bar resets, and you have to start all over again. So yeah, it isn't the easiest taming process to get one of these turtles. It's recommended to have at least two people involved, one to lead the fish and one or more to help defend the turtle. Kind of an annoying process. So now that you've tamed a giant turtle, what can you do with it? Well, many things, I'm glad you asked. You got your standard left-click bite attack. It's okay. Not terrible, but it's not going to do much in an actual fight, as you'll find out. If you hold right mouse button, you've got bubble breath. That looks really awkward. You used to be able to use this infinitely, but unfortunately, bubble breath got nerfed in a recent patch. So now you're limited with how long this thing blows. The bubble breath allows you to provide oxygen for your tribe mates when underwater, and capture small creatures in an air bubble that sends them to the surface. But escaping this bubble is real easy. Just do a melee attack or shoot the bubble to escape. While on land, it also has a nice knockback effect on smaller creatures that can send them absolutely flying. The main feature of the giant turtle is its ability to be a mobile underwater base. What's great is when you dive underwater, six-legged googly creates air bubbles that allow you to breathe underwater. You'll need to make sure that when you're actually underwater, you're strapped down to something, otherwise you're not going to stay connected to your turtle. The Megachelon has two water modes, diving mode, as we already know, and raft mode, which allows you to just float around on the surface, like a raft, without having to hold the space bar. That covers the basics. Let's go more in depth now. The giant turtle has the potential to have an absolutely massive health pool. Now, this thing is extremely slow and has just about zero ability to defend itself. I said the bite was decent earlier, and you also have the bubble breath, sure, but the problem is, bubble breath doesn't work on larger creatures. It immobilizes you and has a cooldown between uses, with a large stamina cost. The bite is okay, but it's just okay. It's got an okay area of effect, but it's slow. An enemy can literally just run around you in circles doing damage till you're dead. So all you can really rely on to survive is its giant health pool. In fact, that's in my opinion really all you should level. Big guy can level HP like an absolute gangster. If you got your hands on a decent level 150, for example, you can dump all HP into it and get upwards of 100,000 health. That's pretty amazing. Let's not forget you can also breed giant turtles to get even better turtles with even more HP. Nothing else is really worth it. Like I said, you're not really going to be fighting with this thing, and really, what's the point of leveling movement speed when you're just so darn slow to begin with? You have to dump just about all of your points into movement speed to see any real improvement there. Also, if you're building on the giant turtle, why would you not pump massive HP into it? Do you want to just die in a few seconds and lose all those mats you put into your build? Speaking of which, you can build on the turtle before you actually have a saddle. Do not do this! If you build on a turtle, then put on a saddle after the fact, you lose all of your structures instantly. We'll look into specific build strategies later, so don't start building before you have your saddle and before you finish this video. As an aside, what has six legs and can crawl up walls? If you guess the Megachelon, then you're right! If you're extremely patient, you can climb up just about any surface in the game with this thing. If a surface is even slightly greater than 90 degrees, you can climb it. It's pretty glitchy, but pretty handy if you're patient. Like, extremely patient. While you're up here, let me tell you, the GT is an excellent berry farmer, but an even greater fiber farmer. Pretty cool. Let's talk about the giant turtle's place in the PvP meta for a minute. Naturally, when you hear about a creature like this with a huge amount of HP and the ability to be built onto, you gotta wonder if this is going to be game busting. Well, I'm just as excited as a magmasaur during a volcanic eruption to share our results after hours of testing. Go look at that video. Let's look at where the turtle takes damage first. You can see anything hitting the head does full damage. Obviously. Shots to the legs also do full damage. Now, what about the shell? Oddly enough, the shell takes damage in a really unpredictable way. Some areas seem to take full damage and others take reduced damage. Pretty unreliable defense, but not a big deal considering you can build defense on the shell. The belly, though. This, interestingly enough, is where the GT is most armored on its entire body. Moving on to the questions everyone is wondering. Is the giant turtle a viable offensive tame? Could it be used as a super soaker for turrets with all that HP? Let's test it out. Before we begin with our tests, let me tell you, the default Megachelon saddle is not what you want to be using. Completing missions may grant you higher tier saddles. If you could get something with decent armor, that's gonna be super valuable to have on these guys. Starting with our control, the Rex. The Rex doesn't have any armor on its body. Headshots and attacks coming from anywhere else affect the damage the Rex takes equally. You can see our turrets here are doing 462 damage per shot on our Rex. All right, good to know. Now, how about the Megachelon? What? Are you kidding me? 1,016 damage per shot? That's more than double what a normal creature takes. That's right. The Megachelon is actually weak against turrets, taking extended damage. Even with maxed out HP, you just get shredded apart in a couple of seconds. Even if you had a really high quality saddle, what's that really gonna do? Make you take normal damage? This is just super disappointing performance from the giant turtle. It's not just the head either. If you get hit in the legs, you take the same huge damage. You can't build to protect the head or the legs either. You're basically just a giant, slow-moving, damage-eating target. You can block the rider, but that doesn't do much. So does this make the giant turtle completely worthless as a turret soaker? Maybe. Here's something that we came up with that could possibly get around these giant drawbacks. The plan is to build down to cover as much of your back legs as possible, then just back up slowly into enemy turrets. Because of how the turrets and your defense work, you wind up taking most of your hits to your underside, where you're most protected. Now, this is the performance we were expecting. Of course, this is finicky and may be unreliable. Maybe the giant turtle isn't the best siege dino. We'll have to wait and see how this all plays out over time. So, you've pretty much got just about no offensive capabilities with the GT, and pretty much no defensive ones either, outside of a large HP pool. Well, where does this thing fit in then? You're probably going to be best served using the Megachelon for PvE. As a PvE dino, this is not bad. It's slow, but it can carry a huge amount of weight. That makes the GT an awesome mobile factory dino. Maybe you take it underwater to farm for resources, or even above land as maybe one big mobile metal ingot forging base. Just travel around and hit metal, smelt it, and take it back to HQ. For PvP, one thing that may be potentially a pretty powerful option is to use these for body blocking choke points. When would-be enemy raiders are caught up having to very slowly work through just a ridiculous meat shield, perhaps you could use your good old magmasaur to light them up. One of the things the magmasaur absolutely excels at is lighting stuff on fire in choke points. You'll light up your own guys, sure, but who cares? It's just meat anyway. One thing to mention is the big turtle does take a lot of fire damage, so keep that in the back of your mind. In certain situations where you'll be raiding a coastal base, check out this build. You'll be able to use it to protect yourself from enemy turrets while also being able to destroy those same turrets and the whole base. albeit slowly. Let me drop a couple extra tips here that I didn't find a place for anywhere else in the video. Did you know your giant turtle has the ability to passively produce rare flowers and mushrooms? Your giant turtle can only be bred, and the eggs can only be hatched at extreme depths. So if you're trying to breed and it doesn't seem to be working, you gotta go deeper. Once the eggs hatch, a good strategy is to cryopod the babies and then move them somewhere else so that it's easier to handle this entire process. The giant turtle is an omnivore, so you can feed it meat or berries. Pretty cool. And that's everything you need to know about the giant turtle! Stick around, I'll be making videos covering everything you need to know about Genesis. Go back and watch the other creatures if you haven't already seen them.